Hello everyone and welcome to the weird, scary and horrible parts of humanity. Derrick Gregory was born in 1949 in Ealing in London. He was the son of Kenneth and Mary Gregory and he had four brothers. He was mentally challenged as a result of childhood illnesses and was later found to have had an enlarged brain cavity since the age of four. As a result of his brain damage, he was reported to be acting like a robot. Gregory was kept in special schools between the age of 11 and 16 when he dropped out. Upon leaving school, he became a painter and decorator. He had a previous conviction for attempted theft of a train from Charing Cross Station. Additionally, he was also charged with loitering and was a member of the Windsor chapter of the motorcycle gang Hell's Angels, but was eventually kicked out. In 1980, he married Carol Cunnington in Hounslow in West London. The pair had a girl, Tara, who was born in the same year. Gregory then moved to Bedford and Isleworth. Throughout his life, he experienced psychological difficulties and had attempted suicide three times. Upon his arrest, the British press labelled him a born loser. Gregory came to know former car salesman 38-year-old Paul Dye, who he had done odd jobs for. He owed Dye £1,000 in 1982. Dye was from Rickings Park, Iver, in Buckinghamshire, and as a major drug dealer and smuggler, he was living a multi-million pound lifestyle. Unable to pay him back, with Dye threatening to kill Gregory, Cunnington and his daughter, he agreed to smuggle car parts and diamonds from Penang in Malaysia and was able to enjoy an overseas holiday as well. Prior to going to Penang, he had never been overseas and did not possess a passport. At the time, Gregory was unemployed and by his own confession, this sounded like an adventure. His smuggling operation was organised by Alan John Humphreys, a 47-year-old who lived in Surrey. Upon arriving in Penang in October 1982, Gregory met both of Dye's contacts in a hotel in Penang and realised that he was to smuggle drugs. When Gregory refused, both men, allegedly named Jack or Ken and Tern or Tyrone, threatened to kill him, telling him that they had spent too much money on him. Both men were never caught. Having never done drugs, Gregory told Tern or Tyrone that he had a bad feeling and did not want to go through with this, upon which he was told that they would do the dirty on him. This caused a vulnerable Gregory to become nervous and he agreed to smuggle the heroin, having never done or seen drugs in his life. On the 7th of October 1982, boarding a plane to Singapore en route to Los Angeles, California, Gregory was found with 14 packets of heroin in his boots and four packets in a Marks & Spencer girdle. The heroin totaled 576 grams. Gregory claimed that he did not know what heroin looked like until he was arrested. Upon his arrest, Gregory claimed to police that he was a 2nd Parachute Regiment at the Goose Green during the Falklands War, a 10-week conflict between the United Kingdom and Argentina over the Falkland Islands between the 2nd of April 1982 and the 14th of June 1982. In reality, Gregory had never served in the army. On the 25th of November 1986, Paul Dye was sentenced to 28 years in prison at the Old Bailey in London, in what was, at the time, the longest sentence for drug smuggling passed by a court in the United Kingdom. He was caught as part of the biggest sting by British customs authorities into drug smuggling, with heroin smuggled in corsets to be transferred in airport transit lounges, with Dye the mastermind of the smuggling. Dye was also fined £201,000. His sentence consisted of 14 years on two counts of conspiracy and smuggling, which were to run consecutively. A third sentence of 14 years for conspiracy was to run concurrently. Unable to pay the £201,000, he was given 2 years in prison by default. Humphreys was turned in by drug smugglers who were arrested in the United States of America, including Kenneth Cunningham, who was aged 35, and served 7 years in Fort Worth Correctional Institute in Texas for attempting to smuggle heroin from Thailand, as well as Philip Chesters from Mapedon in Middlesex, who was jailed at the Metropolitan Correctional Center in New York, as well as John Tipple, who was arrested in 1987 for drug smuggling in San Francisco, California. However, under Malaysian law, Gregory was to face a far worse punishment. Defended by Rascha Rajasangam, who defended Australian Jeff Chambers, who was executed for drug smuggling in 1986, Rajasangam argued that Gregory suffered from a serious personality disorder, with a vulnerable personality characterized by immaturity and antisocial behavior. By the way, we did a video on the execution of Kevin Barlow and Jeff Chambers, so please go ahead and check that video out. However, the Dangerous Drug Act under Section 39B, implemented in Malaysia on the 14th of April 1983, noted that those in possession with more than 15 grams of heroin would be assumed to be trafficking and would receive a mandatory death sentence. Judge Mohamed Dazaldin bin Abdullah, who would go on to become the third Chief Justice of Malaysia between 2000 and 2003, rejected evidence that Gregory was mentally too unstable to be fully responsible for his actions, and sentenced him to death at the Penang High Court in March 1987. Appearing shocked following the sentencing, Gregory stated, "I can't believe I'll hang," but also told British reporters, "It was expected, wasn't it?" Rajasingham argued that under the law of the United Kingdom, Gregory would never have been convicted. Cunnington and Gregory divorced shortly after his sentence, and Gregory never saw Tara after leaving the United Kingdom. Held at Penang Prison, before eventually being transferred to Pudu Prison in Kuala Lumpur for his death sentence to be carried out, Gregory was held with fellow Briton dual Australian citizen Kevin Barlow, who was originally from Stoke-on-Trent, as well as Australian Jeff Chambers. In the book A Long Way From Home, A Mother's Story, written in 1988, Barlow's mother, Barbara Barlow, noted that she met Gregory while visiting Kevin in prison. She stated that he belonged in a psychiatric hospital instead of a prison. Throughout his time in prison, he also became close to Michael McAuliffe, an Australian who was caught smuggling heroin from Penang in 1985, as well as Aaron Cohen, a New Zealander who was convicted of smuggling heroin with his mother Lorraine Cohen. The Observer newspaper noted that he probably had more friends in prison than on the outside. By the way, we did a video on Michael McAuliffe, as well as another video on Lorraine and Aaron Cohen, so please go ahead and check those videos out. On the outside, however, Gregory had few supporters. Cunnington told the British media, "Let him hang," on the 7th of March 1987, and people wrote into the British press stating that they hoped that he died slowly. Indeed, this lack of support extended to Gregory's family. When one of his brothers flew to Australia, he didn't stop down in Malaysia to see his brother, and instead flew straight from the United Kingdom to Australia. One of his few supporters was Barbara Barlow, the mother of Kevin Barlow, who less than a year after her son was hanged for drug smuggling in Malaysia, pressured the British government and Malaysian government in an interview with the Sydney Morning Herald on the 7th of March 1987, asking the Malaysian government to save Gregory's life. While in prison, Gregory became fluent in Malay. He also became incredibly gaunt, with his clothes falling off his body, according to journalists who interviewed him. Prime Minister of the United Kingdom and Northern Ireland, Margaret Thatcher, appealed to the Malaysian government to commute Gregory's sentence to life in prison. This was despite her personal support for capital punishment. Gregory's local MP, Barney Hayhoe, who was a Conservative politician in the Thatcher government, also called for leniency, noting the hypocrisy in sentencing died to 28 years in prison while Gregory was facing the gallows. However, the outspoken Tory MP, the member for Haynes and Harlington, Terry Dix, who also called Nelson Mandela a terrorist, congratulated Malaysia on their tough policies towards the drug trade and wrote to the Malaysian government congratulating them. Gregory sent letters to Queen Elizabeth II requesting her intervention to save his life, but this did not come to fruition, with diplomats noting that she rarely intervened in such cases. Gregory appealed to the Malaysian Supreme Court, with Rajasingham arguing that he was mentally subnormal and did not know what he was doing. This was once again rejected by the court, with Gregory, upon finding out that his appeal had failed, stating, "I'm finished, I'm a dead man." During the week of the 10th of July 1989, a final appeal for clemency by Penang's State Pardons Board was rejected. This sealed Gregory's execution for the 21st of July 1989. On the 20th of July, his mother, father, and one of his brothers visited him for one final time for 3 hours, exiting the prison in tears. Immediately aware that their son was to be executed the next morning, his parents headed to Subang International Airport, which was then Kuala Lumpur's main airport, and left for the United Kingdom. In the hours before his execution, throughout the night, he was clutching a picture of his 7-year-old daughter. He had not seen her since she was a toddler. On Friday, the 21st of July 1989, at the age of 39, Gregory was hanged at 6 a.m. shortly before morning prayers. He was the third Westerner hanged under anti-drug laws in Malaysia after Barlow and Chambers were executed 3 years earlier on the 7th of July 1986 at Pudu Prison. Gregory's execution provoked outrage in the United Kingdom and from the British government due to his evident intellectual disability. Despite a quasi-inevitability about his fate and a lack of expectation from the Thatcher government for mercy following the execution of Barlow and Chambers 3 years earlier, Thatcher also intervened to save Barlow's life in 1986 due to the fact that he was a dual citizen of the United Kingdom and Australia. Gregory's body was returned to the United Kingdom accompanied by his brother Paul. Thank you for watching. Please do yourself a favour and hit that subscribe button and the bell icon to inform you when new videos come out. Also, why not hit that like button and leave a nice comment? It helps more than you know and your support is truly appreciated. Until next time, stay awesome, stay classy, be kind to everyone you meet, and have an amazing day.